the doubt session also if you want. Okay, so this is our customization. Okay, customization is, you can customize it like this. You can specify the width, then you can specify the color, then you can specify the labels of it. So all things can you do inside this. This is your customization part. Okay, so moving on to the next slide, which says creating multiple bars. So I'll repeat it again. For creating the multiple bars, first thing you have to decide is the number of the X points. Why it is so important? Because the bars will be standing on the X point, X axis. So first thing that we decided the number of the X points, that how many X points and where it should be and how it should be. So suppose if X values are not given, then in that case, what you are going to do, you are going to use numpy.arrange function, which will arrange the values for you. So what will happen as you write numpy.arrange, it will give you all the, it will give your, it will generate the values for your X axis. Now, if in arrange, some of the scalar value should be passed, ki aapko kitni values chahiye, that 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. As the arrange function syntax says, that it should have a starting index, end index, and the step value. If nothing is there, then at least end index should be there. So by default, they can start from 0 and they can end it on the point where the index is given. So that values indexing will be decided by the length of the sequence which will be given to you. That will be more clear to you in the programming part, which I'll take the example. Next thing it says that you have to decide the thickness of each bar. Suppose if I'm drawing three bars together on same plot area, then three bars will be there on the same data axis together. So it cannot like all the three bars are overlapping one another. So we have to decide that when, if one bar is standing on 0.3 position on X axis with zero value and it has a thickness of 0.3, then the another bar should come after the thickness of 0.3 has been taken over. So it should, the next data point will be X plus 0.3. I'll explain you more into the programming part. Next we have is, you can give different colors to different data ranges. You can define the different widths for it. No, the width will remain same for all the ranges printed, because agar aap widths change karoge har ek bar graph ke liye, har ek bar ke liye, it will be difficult to then arrange all three bars together on one single place. Bar should be used if you are drawing three bars. Doesn't matter that it is drawing into the one single plot area, but if it is three bars, three time bar function will be called up. If two lines do we draw, we take two times line function. If three lines will be drawn, three times plot function will be called. Similarly for bars, if you are drawing three bar functions will be called. The example is over here. The question says that we have a value which is a list, having list inside it, and then what we have to do, we have to summarize the data of three different trials conducted by company A, create the bar chart that plots three sublists of value in a single chart, keep the width as 0.25. Now see, they have given us three list values, and we have to draw the chart for all the three list values, but we are not knowing that what should be on the another axis, that is the X axis. So what we are going to do, we are going to use our arrange function. You can see the values are given like this, against which we have to plot the graph. But the another axis has not been given. They have told us that they want three bar graphs for three different values, but they have not given us the X axis, that against which axis do you want to put. So the X axis will be np.arrange. Now how does it forecome? As I told you, under fancy value ID, it will be length of the sequence. So we have the sequences. Just let me take the annotation. Okay, so the sequencing over here is 1, 2, 3, 4. So each list is having four values inside it. That's why we have passed here as 4. So it will be length of the sequence. So we have one sequence which is having four values. So the four will pass over here. You can see that it has been plotted, the X has been plotted, and it is still 4.5. That means the final range is 4. Now, what we want to do, we want to plot three bar graphs, because three values are there, 1, 2, and 3. So let's plot the bar graph. So what the values are, the X axis is your X, Y axis is your the values at zeroth position. So value at zero position we have is this list. So this list has been passed as the first argument. Then the color should be blue, width should be 0.25, and label should be range 1. Now for plotting the second bar, again we will call bar function, which says that it should, the value should be now x plus 0.25. Why? Because on x, already on first point, on the first point, already this bar has been drawn. Abhi next bar agar aapko draw karna hai, then it is of width 0.25. So it should then x plus 0.25. X plus 0.25. So the next bar will be x plus 0.25 on here. Similarly, the value 1 will be passed, color will be passed, width will be passed, and the label will be passed. Now for plot dot bar, again for third bar. Now see, it is now 0.50. Why? Because the third bar will again be here on the first data point. Abhi first data point pe 0.25 par bhi hai, 0 par bhi hai, 0.25 par bhi hai. And ye dono ki position chhod ke the third bar should come. So this both bar are of width 0.25 and 0.25. So 0.25 and 0.25 will become 0.50. So now the next bar should come at 0.50, leaving that space. So it should be x plus 0.50, value at 2, color should be green, width should be this, label should be this, and then you can plot it. You can, legend will be put and you can show it. Now see one more thing. Here location is equal to 2 is given. This time they have not given upper right, left right, or upper left, or lower right, something like this. All the four strings are not given, but the integer value has been passed. So in this case, you can see the integer value has been passed. That's why it has been shown like this. So 1 depicts over here. 2 comes here, 3 comes here, and 4 comes over here. You can even see it into the, I can show it into, just a minute, I can just show it into this, how does it work. You can see my spider screen, right? So see, here yes, the location was upper right. So let's just change it to 1. And just, okay. Now just run the program. You can see the output. Just a minute. You can see this is your 1 position. Upper scalar values is that location is equal to 1. Now let's change it and see that what does it will look like on if I write location is equal to 2. You can see that now it is here. Similarly, if I write location as 4, where will it go? So you can see that the scalar values has come over here. Now see, if I do not write the label over here, as I'm mentioning that you have to write the label, but if what if I don't write the label over here? So let's see how does it will show. So you have to try this different thing. So now see, no handles with label. You can see on the console, no handles with the labels found in the legend. You are wanted to print the legend, but the labels are not there. So in that case, the labels should be there. Now one more thing. See, I am working with the spider. So what it does, it by default just put the values at the position. Okay. So what it is doing that by default, you can see this paragraph is ending over here. So by default, it is putting my label just below it. You know that Python is very oriented towards its alignment. So by default, it is taking that this paragraph has been, this bracket is starting from here. So by default, it will, as I press enter, it will by default come over here. But if you're working in ideally, these features are not over there. So you have to keep it in mind that if you're writing something, then the syntaxing should be properly done. Spacing should be properly done. Agar aap ye label ko yahan ja, udhar, at the end, if you'll write it over here, then it will consider it as this paragraph. That means it will consider a part of this function. It will not consider this as a parenthesis part. So you should be very much aware for orientation while working in the IDLE. One more thing, I was talking about the console. This is our console where if you write print, say if I want to write print hi. So in console, what does it happen? As I press enter, output comes like this. And this is your file where you run it. You save your file. So see, I have saved my file with plotting_bar.py. So this is a file. If you write all the commands in file.py file, then you can just run it directly and you will see the output over here. But if you write it over here in the console, you will be pressing Control plus Enter. I have given it into your slides also, that if you're working directly on the console, it will be give, you have to press Control plus Enter to show your this charts. So coming back onto the slides. Okay. So this is our end of the slide. This was all about